حسبي ربي جل الله، ما في قلبي غير الله، نور محمد صلى الله، لا إله إلا الله.
The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said, إنه ليس شيء بين السماء والأرض إلا يعلم أني رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم إلا عاصي الجن والإنس. He sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, there is nothing, there is absolutely nothing what is between the heavens and the sky that indeed knows that I am the messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam illa al-aasi al-jinni wal-ins, except the jinn and the human race. Everything testifies to the greatness of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Be it trees, be it mountains, be it pebbles, everything is testifying that he sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is the greatest human being on earth. Once Sayyidina Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and his blessed companions, Sayyidina Abu Bakr, Sayyidina Uthman, and Sayyidina Umar radiallahu anhum, they climbed the Mount Uhud. And when they climbed Mount Uhud, the blessed Mount Uhud began to tremble. It began to shake a bit. When it started to tremble and shake, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam stepped on it with his blessed ankle and he said, and his blessed heel, and he said, Usbut ya Uhud, fama alayka illa nabiyun wa sabiqun wa shaheedan. He calmed Uhud. He goes, Uhud, calm down, it's okay, what's wrong with you? He goes, only a prophet, a Abu Bakr as-Siddiq and two martyrs upon you. Relax, it's okay. See the love, this tremble was not a tremble of fear. This tremble was a trembling of love of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was once amongst his companions. And he wanted to show them a miracle. So he picked up the pebbles and he held it in his hand. And then he put it towards his ear. And he could indeed hear the speech, the praising of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala from the pebbles. Then it wasn't a thing exclusive to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He then gave it to Sayyidina Abu Bakr. He goes, Abu Bakr radiallahu ta'ala, hear this. He put it in his hand. Abu Bakr put it towards his ear and he heard the tasbih of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Then he gave it to Sayyidina Umar and Sayyidina Uthman and they all heard the tasbih of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala from the pebbles. Qala Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, وَإِنْ مِنْ شَيْءٍ إِلَّا يُسَبِّحُ بِحَمْدِهِ وَلَكِنْ لَا تَفْقَهُونَ تَسْبِيحَهُمْ صَدَقَ اللَّهُ الْعَظِيمُ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala clarifies this event. He says, because there's nothing in this world except that it praises Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, وَلَكِنْ لَا تَفْقَهُونَ تَسْبِيحَهُمْ, except that you cannot comprehend their praises. You cannot comprehend their voices. You cannot comprehend their praise of Allah, except Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Another beautiful waqi'ah where Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, a Bedouin came and goes, show me a miracle. And he goes, okay. Then he saw a palm tree and he went to the palm tree and he goes, come here to the palm tree. The palm tree uprooted himself and came to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam with sujood to his feet. Imam Musiri described this in his Bughah. He goes, جاءت لي دعوته أشجار ساجدة تمشي إليه على ساق بلا قدم. That he called the blessed tree towards him and he came running doing sujood. تمشي إليه على ساق. He came running to him, walking to him upon his ساق, literally means shins. He came on his shins بلا قدم, without any feet. Such was the call of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Such was the intimate love between those things which never had life.
La ilaha illallah, hasbi rabbi jalla Allah, ma fi qalbi ghayrullah.